Scotus and the primacy of the will. Scotus and the primacy of the will. If one comes to Thomas and Scotus from Augustine, the most striking change is that neither is entrusted of the problematic structure of the will, seen as an isolated faculty. But as at stake for them is the relation between will and reason, and the dominant question is which of these mental faculties is nobler and therefore entitled to primacy over the other. Scotus and the primacy of the will. Scotus and the primacy of the will. The great or rather lonely distinction of the Scotus to question the assumption that the universal is monoball and the particular of a superior nature, and that the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. Scotus and the primacy of the will. He had a critical turn of mind, something that is and has always been very rare. Scotus and the primacy of the will. It is the will with its eye for contingency that allows us to transcend our finitude. The primacy of the particular. Resurrection is factual. Creation might not have happened. That's what makes it a miracle. Scotus and the primacy of the will. Prefiguring Kierkegaard's critique of Hegel. Aware of the limits of natural reason, but not therefore irrational. The notion man is irrational was to him itself unthinkable. Scotus and the primacy of the will. Scotus.